Hi everyone. Welcome to the bookshop. If it's your first time here, my name is Shelley. I am just going to do a quick little video. I want to say I'm back. It's been a long time, probably 5 months since my last video, and then quite a while before that. But I have been getting ready to open an Etsy store, which I did last week. It went pretty well. I'm happy about it. But it's called Bookshop Shelley, in case anybody's interested. All one word, same as my YouTube channel. But I have 7 journals listed, and I need to do flip-throughs. I am not doing those in this video, but I just wanted to show you some of the journals that I have, and then I'm going to talk about what's coming up. So, as you can see, I have a lot of neutral-colored journals. I'm really into it right now, and there will be 5 of them. Some very simple ones, writing journals. This one's the most extravagant. Grandma's Attic by My Porch Prince is a kit I used as a jumping off, but it's got lots of charms, and I use some of my actual grandma's ephemera, things like that. And then this one, I love this one. I think it's so unique. The cover is made from shelf liner that I bought at the Dollar Tree. And it also has a really cool inside, something I got from the Dollar Tree, metal tags. I haven't seen anyone using them, and I love them. But it's got a lot of cool stuff in here too. Little metal from Tim Holtz. So I'll be doing all of these. I've got a couple of little ones. I call these Jell-O journals. I use Jell-O boxes as for the covers. And they're mainly writing journals. They do have quite a few tags and stuff, but just mostly writing space. So all of these will have flip-throughs with them. Besides those 5, I have 2 more. These are very colorful. These are both Artie Mays kits. This one is called Butterflies in Blue, and it's got some butterflies on it, plus the fabric, and then the crocheted butterflies. It's a fairly large single signature journal. Some beautiful beads with silver butterflies on them. And then this one is called Spring Mist. And the papers have lots of pink flowers, lots of wild flowers. I use some vintage beads. And these also have the silver butterflies. They have a lot in common, even though they're 2 completely separate kits. But those will each have a flip through also. And so those will be coming up. If you're interested, you can, you know, they'll be posted here and you can look at them. But I wanted to talk about some of the stuff I'm going to be doing. I've been wanting to do craft with me's and tutorials. And I promised a long time ago in more than one video to show how to make faux handmade paper. And that's what this is. These are a little over the top, in my opinion. It's when I was doing it, I threw everything in there. There's glitter and stuff. But basically, you can use plants, stamps. These have butterflies stamped on them, and flower petals, and dried tea, string. But it's just a lot of stuff that you can find around your home. You don't need a lot. Some paper. And then what you cover it with is the backing from napkins. So if you've ever decoupaged with napkins and you pull off that back layer, that's what you use. But you could also use white tissue paper and possibly, I think, even paper towels. White paper towels, you separate them and use one layer, the back layer, the thinner layer. And this is, looks like handmade paper, but it's faux handmade paper. And maybe you won't throw as much junk on yours as I did. I actually made some real handmade paper. That was fun, and we could do that too. It's real simple. stuff is what I just used flower petals on these hydrangeas, some rose petals. And I'm not sure, but the paper, it always turned blue, kind of a grayish blue. Never was real sure how that happened, but next time I do it, I'll be curious to see if it happens again. Because these are different batches, and all the paper came out that way. I was wondering if it was the dye and the stuff in the paper. Anyway, some faux handmade paper we'll be making. I want to do a tab binding journal with fabric tabs. These are really easy. They're fun. They don't take a lot of time to make. You can make them as big as you want, as many, you know, pages. You just need strips of fabric, a little bit of cardstock. And so we'll be doing that. And then this is a stacked letter journal. I noticed when I did a flip through at least a year ago of a blue one, and it got more subscribers than probably almost anything else. But it's got envelopes, I think 7 of them. And you just stack them up. And like I said, I did a blue one, I think using the same kit. And I always wanted to remake this one, even though there's really nothing wrong with it. I had to do some little repairs to where the envelope started coming apart, started splitting from using maybe too much ink or something. But I don't know. I think it maybe just makes it look more like a junk journal. And I never sold it, though. I guess I was worried about the quality. So I don't know. I get weird about that. Anyway, and then this part back here is where the journal is. So you open this and you can make a journal as big as you want, as many pages as you want. But I thought that'd be fun. Maybe we'll do a start to finish on the stacked letter journal. So if anyone's interested, just let me know and I will, you know, get this stuff going. But I think these are two projects I want to do to get started. And then maybe the faux handmade paper. So anyway, for now, that's going to be it. I'm going to go do some flip-throughs of these journals. My listings say that the flip-throughs will be posted as soon as possible. And that was a good week ago. So past due. Anyway, check them out if you're interested. Thank you so much. Like I said, I'm back. I'm going to try to stay regular and do more videos. Okay? Thanks, everybody. Bye.